Welcome back to the channel. This is part two of what has changed now that we've completed almost 100 nights of wild camping. Talking about condensation, what about the window vac?
Well, we decided to buy, we had a window vac at home.
Yep.
But we thought we'd buy one just for the caravan.
Well, the first time we used the window vac that we had, it was fine, and then we inverted it because it wouldn't reach down to the bottom of the windscreen. And if you don't have one that can be used inverted, it sprays water absolutely everywhere. So then we bought a proper one, didn't we?
Yeah, one that you could invert and it worked properly, and it was slightly smaller than the one we had. And it had interchangeable blades, a big blade and a small blade, but it was quite chunky, wasn't it? Quite bulky.
Yeah.
And it did a great job on the front windscreen, but on the side windows, the windows are a bit small for
it. Too small.
Yeah, so it's a bit
tricky. You can change the blade, but once you start doing that, then you have to find a place to store the two blades. And then switching them in and out, you're dripping water everywhere, aren't you?
Yeah.
And it as far as I was concerned, you know, it's more hassle than it's worth.
Plus, you've got to keep charging it up.
Yep.
And it's mains charger.
Mains charger.
So you have to use an inverter.
Yeah, and I don't particularly like using an inverter in the van if I can afford not to. Of course, it makes a lot of noise.
Yeah, yeah.
Which, if you're stealth camping, and you don't want to make any noise. So the Mark 1 microfiber cloth does it all. No need to swap anything. You just wipe it, wring it, and keep wiping, don't you?
Yeah, and then keep drying it out and use it again.
Yeah, I think you've got to accept you're never going to manage to dry the cloth out, though.
No.
You know.
Especially in the wet weather.
Yeah, in the wet weather and winter time, you're going to...
It's going to stay wet.
It's going to stay wet. And so every few days, you're going to have to steam that cloth, aren't you? Otherwise, it will start smelling.
Yeah.
But that's what we're doing. We're giving up on the window vac totally this winter.
And again, saves a lot of space.
Yep, saves space.
Yeah.
Okay. Let's talk about the loos and how that's changed.
Slight difference to how we're using the pee bottles now. So we are making sure now, generally, first thing in the morning, we'll look for a public toilet that's on our route where we're going. And that kills two birds with one stone because we can empty the wee bottles and empty the rubbish at the same time. You generally have rubbish bins where there's public toilets. And then once that's out the way, that's great. You can do that first thing in the morning and get on with your day. And as soon as we've emptied the bottles, we put in a little bit of disinfectant.
Zoflora.
We love the Zoflora concentrated disinfectants. They come in some really nice fragrances, and we take a couple with us so we can chop and change, so you don't get too used to the smell, which is very good. And you only need a tiny little amount, not even a capful, in the bottle every time you empty it to refresh it.
And it was brilliant. It was these using the Zoflora that dictated that we needed to find a loo every morning, because we didn't want to be pouring that away outside in nature, did
we?
No. So that's why we now look for a public toilet.
Yeah.
On looking for the public toilets, we found using an app called Pocket Earth was absolutely fantastic, because all the public toilets are marked on that.
Yeah.
And that helped us tremendously in Ireland.
Yes,
And I'm sure it will elsewhere.
It never let us down
at all. No, never let us down, no.
Yeah.
That was good, wasn't it?
Yeah.
The other thing we've bought is a product called Verna Gel.
Oh, right, yes. We haven't tried that yet, have we?
Haven't tried it, but...
Explain what that is.
I'll explain it. I don't want to get too gross here.
Yeah.
But when you're using the Bivy Loo, right, so this is number two, not number one, if you were ever to have to mix number one and number two, that can present you a logistical problem of how you carry that and get rid of that. So you have to find a way of turning everything into a solid. And some people can use wood chips and all sorts of things like that. But there's a product on the market that somebody gave us a tip somebody on a website, I'm pretty
Someone
sure.
Someone in America, I think, wasn't it?
I can't remember. Yeah. Somebody on a website answered a query and told us about a product called Vernagel. Mm. And so this is, it comes in a box of 100 sachets. Mm-hmm. And if you're ever in that need, you just tip one of them, or actually you can just put the sachet into the bag that you're going to do the business in, and it solidifies everything and then makes that very easy to transport and put it in a bin. I think the box, can you remember how much they were? It might have been about £20 or something for 100.
Yeah.
Well, that would just last us years and years and years, because in all the time we've done it, we've used that loo about four or five times.
Yeah.
Anyway, so haven't used that yet, but we will be using
I'm
that
sure
some
we'll
point in the future.
And let you know. Use it. Yeah.
Now, who noticed? Nobody's noticed, but if you compare our last video to the one before, you will see that there's a completely new roof tent on our van.
Yep.
And the difference is the front portion. On the old version, it was a mesh, but we had problems with the mesh, didn't we?
Yeah, and we kept getting little tears in the mesh, and we thought it was because we were trapping it when we were opening and shutting the roof and causing little cuts in it.
Yeah.
So I did try sewing them up. And they were occurring on both sides, and then we were getting some round the front as well. So we were beginning to think, well, you know, is it really us? But before we could do anything about it, Sussex Campervans contacted us and said that they'd realised that there was a fault with the fabric and that it degenerated when it was exposed to a lot of sunlight.
Yeah. And we've been using our van a lot.
Yes.
A lot
of sun on it as well. So, before we could say anything else, they said, we'll bring it in and we'll replace it for you free of charge. Yeah, no quibble, no problem at all. So we had it done when we took it in for its annual habitation service.
Yeah, and it was done very quickly, wasn't it, really?
Yeah, in a couple of days.
Yeah.
So this new one, it's all plastic. It's got a plastic visor
window
at the front window. So that's great because it doesn't let the wind in.
Yeah.
And it's totally waterproof as well. And then just on both sides, there's a little flap that you can roll up inside. And they've sewn in some of our midge netting mesh for us as well. So it's extra midge proof.
Yeah.
And you just hold the flaps up with some Velcro.
Yeah.
And that gives you some ventilation at the sides. And
also, I love it. I love the new roof tent. And the other advantage is now with those flaps on the side, you can peer out on the side where you couldn't before.
You had no side view.
At night, if you were hearing noises and that, you could just lift the flap inside and have a good look out to the left or right without being seen.
Yeah.
So I really do like the new roof tent. We haven't really used it in anger yet, have we? You know, in driving rain and
not in a storm. No.
Well, we've
only been one night.
Yeah,
in it,
just that
we,
one
since
that
we've
one
had
night.
It, yeah.
But so far, that's really good.
Yeah, and of course it means we don't have our homemade midge nets that we rigged up inside the old roof tent, which looked
it looked an absolute mess. But it was necessary because the original mesh is great. That's stopping flies.
Yes.
But midges just walk straight on through.
Yeah.
You know,
yeah.
The no-see-ums.
Yeah.
Were just coming straight through, weren't they?
Yeah.
And so we went online and we bought some midge netting from a company in Scotland. And it's blooming good stuff,
isn't it? Yeah.
Hard wearing really, really does stop the midges.
Yeah.
And we use a big sheet of that to block out the midges from the door, from the main door, if we want that.
Yeah.
Okay, now, the other thing that was done whilst it was at its safety inspection was an additional safety strap on the roof. Now, some people apparently have had trouble where, when they're driving down the road, that roof has lifted. But all I can say is that has to be user error, because even under the original design of the two heavy duty catches inside that latch shut, and they're then further secured with a safety pin and a strap that links between them. So even if the latches failed, there is absolutely no way that roof can lift. But apparently, two customers have had their roof lift.
Yeah, just a couple.
And so Sussex Campervans offered. They wanted us to have a further safety strap to absolutely eliminate any potential for that. So we went with that, didn't we?
Yeah.
And basically it's a strap that is fitted to the centre of the van. And
It's on a ratchet.
So. Yeah, it's on a ratchet.
So you just pull it tight when the roof is closed.
Yeah.
And then just release it to open the roof.
Now, the only thing I don't like about it is it splits that forward section in half. Mm. And you've got the long tail of the strap sometimes hanging loose when the roof is closed.
Yeah, just have to tuck it in.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But we went for it because, A, number one, it's safety.
Mm.
And number two, if anything went wrong with the buckles that clamped the roof shut, that one strap on its own would hold it shut, wouldn't it?
So
I think it was well worth going for myself.
Yeah, soon get used to it.
Yeah. So that's changed. Let's talk about the gas. We're a lot more relaxed about the gas system now, aren't we?
Yes, well used to it now. Yes. Obviously, when it's new, you don't know how long it's going to last.
Yeah.
And getting it in the winter, we were a bit worried because we were using quite a lot of heating on our first few trips.
Yeah.
But, I mean, it's lasted, well, easily about 4 weeks, I think, we get in the winter.
Yeah.
And then in the summer, it's we've gone all summer. We've only filled it up that once when we were in Ireland.
Yeah.
And we're still on 5 lights now.
Yeah,
so
I would class ourselves fairly heavy users of gas.
Yeah, yeah.
We don't scrimp on the heating.
Yeah.
If it's cold, we whack that heating on.
Yeah.
In the morning, we boil water for both of us to
have a wash,
a proper wash.
Yeah.
Then we cook our breakfast. Then we boil water for washing up.
And a flask of hot water for
the
day.
Yeah, flask of hot water. Yeah. So that's another burn. And then lunchtime, we're cooking and washing up. And dinner, we're cooking and washing up. And again, we're washing at night. So we're really hammering the gas.
Yeah.
And yet it just lasts and lasts and lasts, doesn't it?
Yeah, well impressed with it. Yeah.
Hmm.
Yeah.
Yeah. We used to fill up when it got to 3 lights. Mm. But we don't bother doing that anymore, do we?
No, I think we're more confident now. We can let it get down to 2 lights.
Even one light, I
would.
Even
one light in the summer. Yeah. I'd be a bit more worried in the winter when you need the heating on.
Yeah, I agree, yeah. Mm. And that heavily depends also on where you are in the country.
Yeah.
Because if you've got plenty of opportunities for gas, then there's no real...
No problem.
But if you're up in the wilds of Scotland or somewhere where there might only be one LPG place...
Yeah.
Then we would keep it topped up.
Yeah.
We find that it lasts for ages on 5 lights, but thereafter it will fairly rapidly drop off.
Once it gets down to 4, it goes down quickly,
yeah.
Yeah. So what are your thoughts on the diesel heater instead?
If I could wave a magic wand, I would change it for a diesel heater, which I think might be a bit overkill in such a small van. Well, I'm sure it would be overkill in such a small van, but... the reason I say that is because you can just get diesel absolutely everywhere and it would be
peace of mind.
You wouldn't even think about, would you?
No,
you know,
you
because you know that if you reach a garage, you can both top up fuel to drive and also fuel to heat the van.
Yeah.
So I'm quite attracted to these systems that are that cook on diesel. With a hot plate and also serve as the heater.
Mm.
I really like the idea of that. And so I've been looking at those, not for this van, but for if we ever change, it's not if we ever change.
When?
We will change the van at some point.
Yeah.
But when we change, I think I will go for a diesel heater cooker. And then we would never have to consider fuel ever again, would we?
No, the hunt for LPG.
Yeah. I mean, when we went to the Outer Hebrides, you know, obviously we were in a caravan there, but we had LPG gas, didn't we? So we you know,
Safe fill.
Yeah, we had a safe fill bottles in the caravan.
Right. Yeah.
So You know, I was looking up where do we get LPG on the Outer Hebrides, and there weren't many options.
There was only about two places.
Yeah, only about two places. Yeah. And that, they certain that, you know, there's nothing down the south of the, you know, Barra, was there, or anything like that?
No, that's true.
So, yeah, I'd like the flexibility that diesel would bring.
Yeah.
Okay, that's all for this video. I don't want this to run too long. Join us next time for the final part of this series on what's changed in 100 nights of wild camping.